Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Excellency Esports Light League. We're going to be joining you here tonight as we look to see Degenerates Reformed take on Degenerates Esports, the two teams, the sisters, going at it, seeing who's going to take themselves all the way to finals. I am your play-by-play caster, Zephyr, joined by the lovely Pwnstar Shibby as my color.
Hey, Zephyr, what's up? I'm ready to see some high-level Amateur League of Legends, Light League, you know, best of five action.
I forgot I wouldn't say high level, but these players are definitely talented. I will say that each of them has an absurd skill ceiling for where they're at currently, so I'm really excited, especially to see these two teams duke it out. I mean, I've been waiting for this matchup all season long. These guys, even though they're sister teams, still take it toe-to-toe. You know, it's not always a surefire 2-0 for Degenerate Esports, who are the current first seed team.
Yeah, and really with these best of five series, what I really like, you know, it's different from the best of three and the single game series that, you know, you really have to leave it all out on the field, or in this case, all out on the rift, right? You don't want to go home losing and saying, well, if I would have picked this pocket pick, or if I would have picked this champion here, you know, we might have won. You know, I like it when I see these pocket picks. I like it when I see some unconventional stuff. And I really like it when these teams, you know, pedal to the metal, foot to the gas, kind of, you know, leaving it all out there, as I like to say.
Yes, sir. Just to kind of give you a little bit of a general feel, of course, Degenerate Esports here on going to be blue side tonight. They're running their standard, stereotypical rosters. You've got Thug, Sovereign, Cole, Pixis, Burn in Hell, the usual suspects, the guys who deserve their first seed position into this series. Degenerates Reform have made some slight changes into their roster, it looks like. Adderall being added on here recently 9 days ago, and they did take the win against Divine Ascension Obsidian, which was massive, super surprising in that regard, but still, that is a bit of a new player, and hopefully it's no big deal and it'll just play out the way it does. But Hotsmores and Crinvale, the two stubs, of course, coming in to fill in for what is usually the mid and jungle, and then of course Phlox and Flute in the bot lane.
Yeah, and honestly, I want to see a lot of these teams kind of pick the strong stuff. We're in 10.6 now. We're on a new patch. I've been seeing some Volibear jungle. I've been seeing some different top lane picks. So I kind of want to see some different picks when I look into Degenerates Esports or Degenerates Reform. Both of these teams have some pretty big champion pools from what I've done my research on. So, you know, these kind of comfort picks and stuff like this, even if they're banned off of them, or in this case, you know, banned away, they can still kind of swap onto something else and still be just as effective, it looks like.
Absolutely. And we're already into the banning phase as it stands currently. Degenerate Esports coming right out of the gate, targeting that Kog'Maw, something that's a bit more specific towards what is Phlox. I mean, my apologies, Bixis specifically. So a little bit of a weird on that one, but it's one of those kind of pocket picks that can flesh itself out here. So no surprise on that one. Nocturne in the response as well from Reformed.
Yeah, and Nocturne has been seeing some play in the flex role as well, right? It's a jungler, it's a top laner, it can even be a mid laner. It's a really good tri-flex. You know, Degenerates Esports team usually puts it into the jungle role, but it wouldn't be above them to throw it mid or top, as we see the Elise ban come in and the Thresh ban as well. A lot of junglers just targeting junglers right now for Degenerate Esports.
Well, it is the name of the game, especially for Degenerate Esports. Sovereign has a lot of control on the map, and especially when we went back and we talk about the 2v2 kind of parallels that we see from this team, whether it be Sovereign Kovac, Sovereign Thug, that is a major playing point that they need to shut down if they want to find their way through this best of five, because Sovereign's a key player, man. He may not be the shiniest stone in the box, but he will make those rotations and moves and get the more high extreme kind of showy guys to the place where you want to be.
Yeah, it's interesting that they're throwing these kinds of jungle bans onto Sovereign, right? I mean, you know, these kind of champions not necessarily seen as the best, right? At least not really seen a lot of play. You know, you have the Hecarim, the Udyr, the Lilia, the Volibear, these kinds of god-tier junglers. As Degenerate Esports kind of just B1s Hecarim, like I imagine, and Reformed responding with the R1 on Seraphine's side. So now I think they're going to take Tristana, right? R2 Tristana?
No. I think they let that Senna slide through off that banning phase because they want to pick it themselves, prevent from Esports for picking up. I feel like behind the scenes, there must have been some agreement between these two sister teams where they said, you know, we're going to have a fun game. These bans are definitely looking a little bit more shifty than usual, less serious. I mean, you let that Seraphine slide through the Hecarim as well. I mean, these are some high priority picks just kind of waltz through the draft. I wonder if they're looking to take it like seriously toe-to-toe, like full-skill expression here.
Well, I mean, there's an advantage of kind of letting these OP picks through, right? I mean, if you can accurately, or, you know, if you can effectively play against them, then you don't even have to ban them out. You can focus more bans on comfort picks. You can focus more target bans and stuff like that. So really, in the mid, there's like, this is game one, right? So they test the waters. They see what they can play against. And if they don't like the look they're given, you know, they can just ban it in game two, game three, right? We're in for a 5-game series. So I expect a lot of experimentation, a lot of different bans, reactive bans, and a lot of different comps from these two teams.
We'll have to see how it plays out. I do like to see the immediate response, though, with the Misfortune Rel to secure that bot lane, something a bit more aggressive, and it definitely plays towards the style of esports. And while they're not a bot-centric team, Bixxis and Burn in Hell are still incredible hard carries when they need to. So to give them that power pressure to play off of Sovereign's Hecarim could be another win condition for themselves, and that's something I love to see from teams at this kind of state in the playoffs. Many routes, many win conditions to possibly play through. I mean, that's exactly what you want.
Yeah, and then we see the Volibear being locked in for Generous Reborn. And this is something that could get flexed, you know, top and bottom. I mean, we didn't even harp on the Seraphine, right? That's something that can get flexed mid and bottom. There's a lot of flexibility in Degenerates Reforms. It looks like they're taking yoga or something like that. I mean, a lot of their picks, you know, can be swung around anywhere. The only thing that's a sure for sure is Senna, right, in the bottom lane. And that's really what you're going to get. While on Degenerate Esports side, it's a lot more standard. They take the Misfortune with the Rel. I like the setup. I like the, you know, Magnet Storm into Bullet Time. I think that's a very strong combo, and I think it's very underused right now.
I think we've seen it many times, though, from Esports to give it the proof that it deserves. It's got its power. It's got its presence, and they do a great job of making it work. But either way, consistent jungler bans still being thrown out. They believe that Volibear is going to be rotating towards the top side into the hands of what will be Adderall. They still don't think Hot S'mores has picked it out yet. So there goes the Jarvan. There goes the Lilia, pressuring those two out as well. I'm curious what Reformed is going to respond with, or whether they'll actually leave that mid pickup for a counter.
Yeah, and this R4 is super crucial, right? They want to try to save, in my opinion, they want to kind of save their mid pick for counter pick. Or if, like you said, if they want to play through their top lane, it looks like they're going to, you know, just throw in the Gragas there. Very standard, solid pick. But again, Volibear, Gragas, two champions that can go jungle.
I was about to say, super flexible style.
Yeah.
We've seen plenty of Gragas tops in the league, all right? That's not a surprise for me at all at this point. I mean, maybe week two, all right? You guys were throwing that out one there, and I was getting a little confused. But now, at this point, you can't trick me. Fool me once, and shame on me. Fool me twice, and I'm but a fool. Either way, Volibear could potentially rotate, but I'm going to place my bets and say that Adderall will be taking the bear onto his belt. But the response here from esports is a little interesting. Usually Kolbox likes to orient himself towards something a bit more team fight. He does still have that presence to cross map with the Twisted Fate, but this isn't quite those AoE air, you know, Orianas or Syndras that, you know, we might be used to him seeing. So he's looking to get aggressive here, I would say.
Yeah, and he just wants to impact the map, right? He, you know, with the Twisted Fate pick, it's not about lane. It's not a lane pick, right? You want to ult, you know, ult on cooldown either top or bot lane. In this case, it's a lot of CC setup with the Misfortune and Rel. I mean, even in the top lane, right? Setting up that gold card and then getting the Urgot E into the, you know, ultimate into just death and being shredded apart into a million pieces. As we see, is that a Yorick pick?
Yeah, that's rare. You don't see that one around very often, and I welcome it, all right? Split push pressure. And actually, now I'm a bit confused. I believe that's going to be York. That's York top. It has to be York top. Gragas mid. Well, then who goes bot, Pwn? All right, come on.
It's
Think
Senna
with brain cells here. Think with brain cells here.
Senna ADC, Gragas support, Volibear jungle, York top, Seraphine mid. I think that's what it is.
I'm going to place my bets. York top, Volibear jungle, Gragas mid. Gragas mid, Senna Seraphine bot.
Okay, well, you know, like we said, Generous Reforms practicing yoga. I mean, they don't even know where their champions are going to go, so I guess we don't know. While Esports on the other side is very standard, you know, they can't really flex anything around unless they go for the legendary AD carry Twisted Fate, which I've only seen in my solo queue games, unfortunately. But
fortunately, that sounds great, Pwn. You don't like AD Twisted Fate?
Oh, I love it with the, you know, with the gold card doing
yes,
negative.
Yes, sir. Damage. You know what? I personally think it's the highest quality Twisted Fate you can get around the scene, and you're honestly just sleeping on the pick, bud.
Yeah, it's a sleeper pick. But let's get into draft a little bit more. So who do you think, you know, once we find out where all the positions are going, where all the champions are going and stuff like that, you know, where do you think the advantage lies for Degenerate Esports, at least, since we know kind of what they're up against and kind of what their game plan is? Where do you think they're going to try to look to play? Where is this TF going to go? Bot, top, is he going to kind of be a third jungler? You know, as I say, support is the second jungler. You think TF will just kind of roam in with his jungler with Hecarim and run over whoever's jungling on Reform's side?
Honestly, to go off of that, they have an incredible pick comp to play off of and get some rotations happening early, like you bring up with that Twisted Fate. But not only that, Sovereign on the Hecarim with rotations can make for a nasty combo, the pair of those two, as we get the teleport, as we get the rush in from them. Because Fug can take Adderall. I don't care what anyone says. Fug is absolutely insane in the top lane. And while Adderall, I've yet to see too much from this guy, performance in Divine Ascension Obsidian's game leaves a lot to be expected. So I'll put some bids on towards the top side. I will say Bixxis and Burn in Hell are strong, but Fox Zero and Flute Loops are no sleepers to go into. So if I had to pick, I'd say keep it towards the top side, play off Fug, because if he gets ahead, your entire team rolls over. And if you find an applicable situation, if you find an applicable situation for Bixxis and Burn Hell to find kind of a play into Fox Zero and what looks to be the Gragas on Flute Loops, I don't know. There's a lot of sustain that lane. There's a lot of disengage, especially going into the casket. It's not going to be that easy for them to find what they need unless Reformed is really playing out of position, and sometimes they do. So personally, I'm gonna keep it towards the top.
Yeah, and what we don't realize about the Gragas pick is that it's really good at interrupting and blowing and, you know, just kind of getting ults out of the way, right? The moment Rel kind of engages, uses Magnet Storm, the moment, you know, Gragas or Flute Loop sees that Misfortune is getting her bullet time off, he can just throw the R, the huge casket, interrupt everything and mess up their whole game plan and kind of return damage. Gragas, somebody that's super tanky, right? It's going to probably take the Aftershock into the lane. So once he gets that CC off, Senna can kind of kite back, get the heals off and look to turn from all the burst damage that Misfortune and Rel will be doing. So a really good 2v2, interesting matchup. Would love to see once they hit level 6. How the lane turns. But I think on Degenerate Reform side, they should just look to, you know, get even in the lanes, right? I don't think they should be looking play necessarily towards one lane. They have a lot of scaling. I mean, Yorick getting him ahead, like, yeah, he'll just split push with Maiden. I mean, Seraphine is Seraphine. She's going to provide free Ruby Crystals, free heals, all this kinds of juicy, juicy stuff. Well, Senna and Gragas are just going to look to scale in with the Rage Blade, you know, the Kraken Slayer, the Rapid Fire Cannon, the amount of souls that you can get, and Gragas just gets super tanky. So definitely different kinds of comps on each team. We'll probably see Degenerates Reform give up the first one or two dragons before they really want to team fight and get those items. So I think it's on Degenerates Esports to win the game, but Reformed can definitely, you know, stall out laning phase and kind of nullify them and kind of just even it out. Even if they're down 1,000-2,000 gold, they're still ahead in terms of just how strong their champions are.
I think there's a lot of pressure to play around this team as a whole once they come together. Much to your point, we're looking more towards that mid to late game scaling to play into their favor. I do still think this comp lacks a real heavy source of damage. While it is very mixed across the board and they do have alternative positioning coming through, it's nowhere compared to Esports' current composition from them. They have a massive pressure that they can apply, whether it's Ubrixis on Misfortune, Sovereign on the Hecarim, Kolbox Twisted Fate, we know he gets insane on that. Fug, of course, is going to be disgusting no matter what. I mean, I feel like from all angles, the pressure will be there. Whereas, you know, it's a bit more, you have to play cohesive. You have to have that communication from Reformed. If they're not all on the same page, suddenly Fox Zero's out in the back, getting destroyed by Sovereign. Crimvale's getting pulled in by Fug, going out early. You know, if this team isn't playing front to back perfectly, maybe putting in that 4-1 split with Adderall to put the pressure down and kind of screw up the minds of Degenerate Esports, then I could see it falling apart very quickly.
Yeah, it is a very, like, razor-thin line kind of composition, as you'd say. It feels like more that Degenerates Reform is going for this kind of attrition comp, right? With the Gragas, with the Volibear, these two huge tanks, and then Senna and Seraphine are there, both of them healing them, right? And they're just kind of, you know, in your face, like you mentioned, front-to-back. But I think even front-to-back is a little bit, you know, it's more than that. It's I'm gonna sit here, I'm gonna stand my ground, and you're gonna have to chew through these massive health bars, you're gonna have to chew through these massive shields, and we're just gonna be overall annoying. You can dive us, you can burst us, but that's not gonna be enough. You have to catch one of us out of position, like you mentioned. And I like the Yorick pick, actually. You know, not seen as much, but, you know, if you can get Fugnuggler away and you talked him up a lot, if you can just kind of get that 1v1 isolation and get him away from his team, it looks like Reformed kind of has the better 4v4 team fight, in my opinion.
Yeah, I would agree with that to a degree. If Esports doesn't get the jump, then Reform definitely has it. But either way, we're going to leave it up to the players themselves. They're going to be showing the metal, putting the pace to this first game out here. We're going to be right back as we make our way towards the Rift. Stick around for an exciting game one.
Begun, and metal shall prevail, for we know what they have done. Five legends of our realm who sought to follow the path of their dark musings, but they did not know what they had summoned. Pentakill. To these creatures, there is but one thing left to do. Heavy metal.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Excellency Esports. If you've just been joining us, we're bringing you Degenerates Esports versus their sister team, Degenerates Reformed, here into our semifinals best of five. I am your play-by-play caster, Zephyr, joined by the lovely Pwnstar Shibi as my color.
Yeah, and, you know, we're going to kind of get into this jungle five-point defense, but I want to kind of go in on the runes, right? This Volibear not going for the Predator kind of chem tank build that we've seen, instead going for the press the attack, and we're in 10.6, and he might go for the Divine Sunderer, you know, Zhonya's Hourglass build that Self-Made from Fnatic in the LEC has been kind of popularizing a little bit. And really, I want to see this jungle matchup early game. Like you mentioned, Sovereign, somebody that can control the map, really dictates the flow of Degenerates Esports game. You know, I want to see how you can impact this game and really, you know, get past this Volibear, Yorick, Seraphine kind of really annoying attrition kind of style composition they have.
Right, because if esports does not put pedal to the metal here, get the favor in their fall or the court. Oh, man, that is some terrible analogies to just fluke out of the water. But I will say, if they don't take the pace early here, you definitely enable some of the power from Reformed. And I feel like we've beat the bush on that point, but it cannot be stated any better way. So we'll watch, we'll wait and see. Big power players, Sovereign, Hot, S'mores, potentially Kovacs rotating, especially once he hits six and has the Destiny available.
Yeah, and we'll see some opposite jungler starts as well. So each of the junglers probably likely to full clear, get their own cute little scuttle crabs, be level four, and then look to impact the map about 315, 320 in. But really, who is your marquee matchup for this game?
Oh, I'm watching top lane, baby. I could care less about any other lane. Fug has shown me time and time again that he is a star carry, and Adderall's completely new to me. I got to see a little bit of presence from Divine Ascension, and while it was good, I'm curious to see how it paces up against Fuggin. I love the pick on the Yorick already, so I'm already kind of hyped to see how this matchup plays out. But other than that, I guess bot lane, Bixis and Burn in Hell, while they aren't, they're already getting pressured away from this wave. They're already pulling back, and they're on what is usually some pretty aggressive champions. They lose that level 2 advantage immediately. I mean, look at this.
Yeah, they're just getting pushed, and they're not respecting it. Oh,
the flash comes out. Speaking of not respecting, I guess Fox Zero, not really respecting the pressure from Burn to Hell that was possible, and the flash was necessary. Had he been stunned through there, I could definitely see Bixis pulling forward with a great kill. So yes, they are the better bot lane into the situation, but they also need to be respectful.
Yeah, and really, they need to respect the power of Rell and her engage. Right now, a flashless Senna is easy pickings for this Rell, right? Still has the flash, still has the ignite, can get all of her abilities off and put over as we see some fading the top lane.
A little bit from Adderall and Fug here, and the cage going to make sure that Fug can't aggress, but still taking him half is an achievement in itself.
Yeah, I mean, Yorick returns with the pocket sand and his little goosey goblin. As we see this mid lane, kind of just a bit of a wash, really. It's kind of a boring lane, really, until TF hits six. Seraphine's just kind of heal up, hit you from far away with those musical notes, and TF is just going to kind of throw wild cards at you. So
yeah,
I like the focus in on the top lane. I like to see, how these... Oh,
ooh, speaking of top, yeah, I was about to say Sovereign coming in there. Great pullback from Fug. That's going to set this up beautifully as Adderall puts the cage down. It does slow up Sovereign for a bit, but as he makes his way towards that alcove, I think Adderall is all but dead here. He goes for the massive flash, and there's the speed up from Sovereign. He was saving it, finds himself the first blood immediately.
Yeah, Ed, we saw the power of the cage only if Volibear was there for that counter gank. I wish they kind of would have scouted out. Ooh.
Hold the thought, but I guess the flash saves the day. Not quite, but there's actually the response from Sovereign coming in immediately from the top side here. He does get a great pushback onto Crimvale, but not quite able to launch it down as Hot S'mores coming back around, hooking into the horse himself, and he's going to be taken out, finding its way over to Crimvale.
Yeah, and really just overstaying on Hecarim's part, really gets the damage off on the Seraphine and the Volibear, but you have to know that Volibear is in this bot site. He didn't counter gank you topside. He didn't even show anywhere. He's got to be hovering around this mid lane. So kind of greedy on Hecarim's part, starting off amazing, getting the kill into the top side and just kind of throwing it away, throwing a lot of the tempo he got off of that away in the mid lane. A really good response by Volibear, though. Very smart stuff, taking the Raptors away and getting on that counter gank.
And that's exactly what we want to see this game, the matchup between Sovereign and Hot S'mores. And while Hot S'mores is going to be playing a bit more reactive because of the playstyle of Volibear into this, Sovereign still showing pressure on that top side. I mean, it's still even in my eyes at this point. They're both showing adequate presence in their own respective unique ways. So no one quite has taken the medal just yet.
Yeah, and we're going to look for Sovereign to just kind of predict where Volibear isn't, right? Volibear really good at turning around these ganks and being arguably one of the best counter gankers, right? Can get the stun, can get the shield, the E, his cooldowns are relatively low, while as Hecarim, his W and E cooldown are respectively like 12 and 15 seconds, right? The only thing that has a low cooldown is his Q, for Volibear's sake, he's got a lot of low cooldown ability to see some action.
Yeah, Volibear, as you bring up, coming through this bot side, they get the massive knockup stun onto Bixis. He's going to be forced to flash as Ignite ticks down. The casket doesn't quite get him as Flute is taken incredibly low. We got the major teleport coming in here from Kovacs. He's assessing the situation. Can't quite find the yellow card when he needs to. Gonna be backing off as Crimvale steps up and gets a massive root and blast onto Bixis. He's gonna be punched out for Guzzard, but that's gonna be the double root from Voxer as a response as the stun comes through with Hot S'mores. Crimvale steps up a little too far forward as he's punished out by Cole. Now in the top lane, Fug and Sovereign return gank onto Adderall, pressuring this man from the lane for another kill on the Sovereign. It's two for Degenerate Esports.
And putting the Gravedigger back in his grave. Sovereign's really just abusing Yorick. A flashless Yorick is the easiest person to gank, in my opinion. The little wall that he has, the arena that he creates, the Thunderdome, as you may call it, isn't really that effective this early into the game. It only takes one hit to kind of get around. And, you know, Hecarim and Urgot are really good at setting up these high CC plays. I'm not allowed to talk.
Oh, not a lot of it all. Kobox back in the bot lane, finds that stun on the Fox Zero. Stepping out too far is going to be taken out as well. And it's so sad because you have Flute and Hot S'mores just a little bit north taking that dragon there.
Yeah, that's a little greed on Seraphine's side, right? Getting out to shove this lady, doesn't really need to fix the wave here. Can kind of just leave it as it is. Looks like it was just going to freeze within the mid lane and, you know, could have just gone to the dragon and secured an easy ocean, but paid with it for his life as we see some.
Yeah, no, we're good. Fug, he's feeling himself as it stands right now, but he isn't quite the crab god yet.
Yeah, and he's really looking for those long-range ultimates, right? Kind of reel you into his meat grinder. If you can just get half that damage off, you know, Hecarim, somebody that does a lot of burst, going for the Sheen route as well, so he might even just build Divine Sunder or String away from that, you know, tank build. Ooh. Oh, my God.
Onslaught of Shadows into the Fear. Crimvale going to be using that Encore for the double charm, but I don't think it's enough. Kobox picking that one up for himself, and Esports putting pedal to the metal.
And, you know, Sovereign just demonstrating why he has the superior jungler in hand right now. Volibear not able to match his clear speed and his gank speed, you know. Kind of just here to pick up some waves, some minions. He's pretty happy about that. But really, Sovereign is just impacting the map so fantastically well. Onslaught of Shadows, his ghost is up. He's getting the damage down. And Seraphine, somebody that really needs to respect that chain CC that Hecarim and Twisted Fate have, right? I feel like Sovereign is set up to do so much with these two solo laners, right? In terms of CC and damage and everything like that.
Absolutely, 100%. I will say, Esports now in a great position here. They set up some of their major carries where they want them. Sovereign and Kobox, especially. This is that jungle mid matchup we talked about earlier. This is where you see the Shining Stars really start to come out here from Esports. And we do have still some great pressure control from Fox and Flute in the bot side, as well as a little bit of kill presence on Crimvale. But I don't know if it's quite enough to ebb and flow, because in one hot moment, I can easily see Cole and Sovereign starting to ramp the pace on this game even further. So definitely need to see that kind of war of attrition that you discussed earlier really come out here, or else Reformed is not going to be in a great position mid to late game.
Yeah, and the Destiny is back up for TF, so we'll want to pay attention to where he kind of throws that. He might just throw in the top lane. They look like they're kind of prepping a dive of sorts as Yorick kind of ults, and then, you know, bot lane getting some pressure. I think Hot S'mores has accurately just realized that where he kind of needs to play, you know, playing towards his strong side bot, getting the Senna even a little bit ahead will help him out a lot, as we see some pain in the top lane.
Yeah, Fug taking a little bit of the presence, and I like to see that the fact that even though he does find himself in a great kind of gold lead advantage against Adderall, Adderall's still taking punches, playing around that Maid of the Mist to make sure it's not quite out of it just yet. And sadly, Hot S'mores wasn't able to find anything bot lane, so he's going to be backing up, rotating towards this top side. So who knows? Maybe we'll finally see that gank towards Adderall. Maybe we'll see Fug go down for once.
Yeah, and Yorick is so strong with Maiden up, right? He can do percent health damage, you know, the Maiden providing almost half a champion's worth of damage onto Adderall. So that lead that Urgot got, I mean, he only has two assists, right? He's not that much farther ahead in relation to gold-wise, right? I mean, he has about 30 CS. He's going to creep up on 30 CS above, but, you know, the stats that Maiden provides is so crucial. It kind of makes up for the gold lead that Urgot kind of received from those two ganks he got early into the game. As we see some attention in the mid lane.
Yeah. At this point, though, everyone's kind of reset on the pressure here. Kind of back to those lane-to-lane matchups. We're still waiting for Hot S'mores and Sovereign to make their apparent plays. You got Hot S'mores trying to find something on the Cole right now, but I don't think it's going to really come out in any performance. Cole's pretty good at playing it safe when he needs to. And spots him out quite easily, actually.
Oh, as we see, maybe some action to the mid lane. Yep.
Yep. Sovereign going in on Hot S'mores there. Good encore charm onto Sovereign. He's going to go deep into the back line outside the side, but the Stormbringer response makes sure he goes down, and Adderall immediately there before Fugnuggler to prevent anything further. Get a good slow on Cole, but the golden card to prevent Hot S'mores. Stun comes through. Dawning Shadow shields it up, but it's not quite the damage they need to take the man out. Still, Reform find themselves a great kill.
Yeah, and, you know, really good turnaround from Volibear and Seraphine there. We just kind of saw the power of their champions, right? Volibear getting the extra health from his R by, I believe it's 200 rank one, and Seraphine just providing so much heals and damage even this early on. I mean, Volibear couldn't really die, right? Even though, you know, Seraphine got ulted by Hecarim, I was expecting the Fear Beyond Death from Urgot onto the Seraphine, but he didn't really want to fire it away. So couldn't get the return kill. Volibear almost getting that second kill in the mid lane, forcing Kobox to teleport, and now TP advantage is on Seraphine's side.
Absolutely. But I do like the response here from Esports. They kind of manage in their wearied pace, and they're going to pull back towards this Infernal, even up the Dragon score a little bit. So it might not be much, and I'm actually surprised that Reform did get that first Dragon, as we kind of discussed maybe them dropping a few early. But this kind of evens that back out, like I said. And trust me, it does matter later on when the pressure is on and you actually have to go to contest that versus something like Baron, or even the presence of Soul Point or Elder, even when that comes online. So everything, all steps of the way, they matter. I mean, hot takes here, let me tell you.
I mean, it is Soul Point, right? It's Cloud Soul, so it's not the worst dragon to lose, even if you give up the first, you know, two or three. I mean, this Soul Point is going to be delayed at least by 15 minutes, right? Just because of the dragons on each side. So this kind of favors into Reform side on how they want to scale with the Senna and, you know, the Seraphine heals and the Volibear tanking and all this kind of stuff. And before Yorick kind of becomes the split pushing menace that you're going to have to send more than one person to, right? As Urgot is so good in the 1v1 lanes, you know, Yorick kind of has that maiden in there, just kind of skew things in his favor. And that's going to become more and more of a factor as we get later onto these levels and later onto the gold and stuff like that. So really, like I mentioned, and like we mentioned before, and we've been harping on, Degenerate Esports kind of has to start amplifying their pace, kind of start putting it, you know, pedal to the metal. It's only a 1k gold lead for them right now.
Absolutely. We do see, oh, the cancel on that Rift Herald. I don't know if the timing was expended just a little bit too late, but it doesn't find anything. It's a huge waste there from Esports.
Yeah, they played it in the mid lane, but they didn't even try to, like, baby it, right? They didn't try to get it across the finish line. He kind of just dumped it in there and said, here, it's your problem now, Kobox, and he can't really defend it with the mana that he's sitting on right now. Pretty much none until he gets back to base like he did just now. So just a huge waste on gold and getting some gold into the pocket. We see the Everfrost build onto TF.
Ooh, big flash with the explosive casket there. It pressures out Flute Loops. It's a weird position for Bixis, as it actually puts him closer to turret of all places. And actually, I believe that saved the day. So great play from Flute Loops to kind of disengage in that displacement. This goes back to a little bit of the sustain and peel we talked about in this lane when it was first drafted out.
Yeah, and that's kind of been the counters to Rell right now. It's just kind of these disruptive disengages. So of course, usually we see the Alistar played into it because he can headbutt. Gragas, you know, thematically works the same way with his, you know, body slam and his R and all this kind of stuff, and his Q even, to slow and kind of take terrain control out of the equation, right? So really good stuff. I mean, Misfortune and Rell kind of aren't really getting what they're looking for, and it's really kind of stunting their power, as Senna, on the other hand, is already back with Kraken Slayer. So this next dragon in the next 2 minutes, hopefully we'll see a skirmish come in, maybe we'll see some action, but it looks like right now that they're gonna have the stronger one item power spike on Degenerate's Reform side.
Ooh, and Adderall taking a huge trace. Fug is going to go low in response from that Dawning Shadow. Nothing quite happens as yet, but the wave is crashing into turret here. One good fear. Actually, doesn't quite have it, but the rotation from Sovereign is there. Sovereign going to come into the top side, going to get the immediate responses. Adderall taken low. There's the turret. Unstoppable onslaught to make sure he gets out of that one just safe.
Yeah, and without the Thunderdome, you know, Yorick can't really do much. Even then, he's still like a really easy, you know, dive target. A Seraphine kind of come in late, picking up the wave. But, you know, we're going to see that one.
Oh, no. Destiny stun, gold card, and an immediate response as that wave crashes into turret. a little bit too aggressive from Crinvale being so far out of position. Great punishment from Degenerates Esports.
And Volibear is just two steps behind, right? He's right there. He's at Krugs. He saw the Seraphine die in his eyes, but couldn't get there. And that's kind of been the name of the game, right? Hecarim is always there. You know, Sovereign's been playing exceptionally well, coordinating these dives and just kind of being one step ahead of Volibear. And really, like we mentioned, Volibear kind of has to be there for the counter gank since, you know, Degenerates Reformed is, you know, letting this game slip away from them.
Blue, too far forward, teleport from Fuck. He misses the ult, but it doesn't matter. The Ignite from Burn in Hell finds the kill either way. And like you said, you see Reform slowly losing the grasp on this game.
Yeah, and amazing TP by Urgot, right? Getting in there, it's a double value TP because he's there for the dragon. He almost was there for the kill secure. Missed the R, but I really didn't really need to use it. I wish he had it for that dragon as... You know, maybe Degenerate Reform is going to look to take this fight as TF is in the top lane. He has the TP ready, so we'll see what happens.
Fugnuggler stepping back into Fox Zero here. There is the root response as Crimvale is going to play off it as well, but he flashes forward immediately to find the instant collapse onto Fox Zero. Turns back around as Burnhell misses the stun, but there's the bolt time over the wall. Massive pullback as the stun comes through. Fug is now taken low as Hotsport tries to launch forward. Stormbringer to slam down and secure the kills. A major teleport's coming through for a double stun. The Bixis onto Burnhell. Teleports down as Sovereign comes through, but an explosive casket disrupts the whole team fight. Two kills find their way over to Reform. Three in total. They're back, baby. Not quite out of it just yet.
And Degenerates Esports, Fugnuggler getting a little hyphy, thinking he can kind of kill the whole team. And I love the stride breaker. I love it on Urgot. It's a very good item. Allows him to engage from distances that you wouldn't expect.
Oh, look at this. And there's the unstoppable onside. He actually manages the steal, and he's going to chugga away. Choo-choo, hooray. This man finds himself the dragon in the face of the entire team and doesn't even go down.
Yeah, and just not really protecting against the Hecarim. I wish they would. Oh, I don't get to talk.
You don't, not at all. Sovereign, though, steps back in, and he doesn't quite realize the rest of the team is there. Dawning Shadow, Burn Held, though, to get the response. Sun's out, Magnet Storm pulling Hotsmores back, but he's taken low as the rest of the team from Reform begins to collapse. Fug looking to come around the backside onto the wave of Hotsmores, but it doesn't matter. Flute's on the response. The rest of the team, 4v1, blasts through on Fugnuggler. Two kills in favor of Reform to continue the chase, but Cole and Bixis look to be out.
And Urgot thinking he's playing Call of Duty, trying to get this massive 1v4 flank, trying to get the spray down, kind of just walks in awkwardly, stride breakers in, and then just is like, oh, hey guys, what's up? I'm here to crash the party, but really just pays for it with his life. And, you know, just as many good plays as Degenerates Esports making, it kind of looks like Thanos was perfectly balanced. They make just as equally bad plays, you know, overstaying and, you know, Reform just kind of getting these handouts left and right, you know, taking them for free.
This is what I mean. Degenerates Esports and Reform, they go toe to toe. They're not teams without faults. Esports might be the top of the league right now. They might have that first seed, but they are prone to being over aggressive with their talented players, a bit too kind of egocentric as they go for those single odd kills into the 4v1 where you find yourself in death very quickly. Whereas Reformed, I feel like they're a much more balanced team. They just don't quite match up in terms of full birth skill as of yet, but still into each other when the bulls butt their horns. It goes even, man. I mean, it's only a 1K difference right now.
Yeah, and it feels like Degenerate Esports had it for a bit, right? They've just been overstaying just a little bit too long. These kind of micro plays that you don't usually see get punished in solo queue and some other league sometimes. But, you know, these teams, it looks like they really know each other. They probably scrimmed each other for the full 8 weeks before this. So they really know each other's tendencies. Now, you mentioned Adderall is kind of new in the top lane, so they may not know what he does. But a lot of Degenerate Esports, there's a lot of tape on them. There's a lot of, you know, game tape, scrims, everything like that, as we see some action in the top.
Yeah, Adderall coming through Flute Loops, rotating the support, the man himself. This is the aggression we're used to seeing. Explosive casket, a missed fear beyond death. Adderall finds himself the return, the revenge that we have been necessarily watching here. And finally, Reformed, they're evening it out. 9-9. Gold Zone was back where it needs to be.
And Flute Loops has been really good on these roams, even from like level 3, you know, was able to burn the TF flash super early on and just understands his role as a support, is being the second jungler.
Burn, what are you doing? A little too far forward there. Stunned out. The Root comes through. Magnet Storm, maybe too late as the Stormbringer secures that kill, but the response from Sovereign is hot. They step back as Hot S'mores is stunned through by that gold cart, and he's going to go down in response. Now the bullet time pressuring Reformed away from this mid league. It's going to look to be just that one for one as it currently stands, though.
Yeah, and support for jungler here. I think at this point, just Rell is so crucial as we see some just split pushing, just being a menace in the top lane.
Yeah, but he's going to be punished out. Adderall 3-1. There's not much to say here. Thrown through, Kobox picks that one up.
If I'm Adderall, I'm saying worth, right? Two turrets, gold to myself. I mean, you know, not a lot can be gained with the kill that was on Yorick, right? Baron is up. They're definitely not going to go for it. No dragons are up. I mean, ideally, you would have loved to see Yorick get out alive, but right. Getting two turrets, getting that tempo, you know, even with the tempo that Esports gets from it, you know, they can't really do much with it. So two turrets. Oh.
Hey, hi, Cole. Nice to see the Destiny from me into the bot lane. He's actually taken incredibly low in response. I know he was going to pick up the kill. I was memeing that a little bit. But either way, another rotation from Esports playing off of their pick potential and finds its way onto box.
Yeah, and, you know, Fox Zero not really respecting Destiny, not really respecting the amount of damage that can come out. You know, Everfrost Twisted Fate is so good because he can lock you up with gold card, then lock you up with the Everfrost and get a guaranteed wild cards onto you and just kind of wail away at you with the rest of his abilities. So, you know, just a lot of bursts coming out from Kobox with the Electrocute and everything like that. Dragon is up in 30 seconds. Senna is down. TPs are up for both mid and top on both teams. So we're going to see some, hopefully see some cool flanks. Maybe not the one we saw earlier from Fog Nuggler, but a better one, hopefully.
Absolutely. Hopefully he'll be able to get into that back line finally. We'll see why the Urgot pick is kind of the shining star here. But honestly, Kobox, that's the guy I'm kind of turned my attention to. 5-0-2, double item completion, constant rotations on top of it. Card selection there just as well. He's playing very, very well. But now the response here immediately, the stun comes from Hot S'mores back into the back line. A massive fear from the Onslaught of Shadows as the rest of the team begins to be wiped through. Fox stepping up, explosive casket to dissuade the pressure, but Adderall still back too far forward. Big Root, but still Fog gets the pressure a bit into that back line. Either way, two kills, jungle, mid, gone here for Reform, and the Dragon now in the hands of Degenerates Esports.
Yeah, and Flutloops really needed to play that fight exceptionally well, but he couldn't. He needed to get the interrupt onto the MF bullet time. That bullet time just chewed away at the life bars of Genetics Reformed. You know, even with the double heals that comes out from Seraphine and Senna, you know, he really needs to interrupt that big AoE ultimate that MF has, right? Right. Couldn't do it, couldn't cut it. You know, Degenerates Esports grabs another dragon, pushes Soul Point to about 28 minutes, and then Cloud Soul is fantastic for a lot of these guys, right? Hecarim especially getting so much value out of it. Rell, you know, can get more people onto the Magna Storm. Even TF to an extent can kind of chase you down, even if it's a little bit of a far Destiny case. The only two people not really getting too much out of it is probably the Urgot and the MF, just because their ultimates, you know, are a little bit longer lasting and require a little bit more time to activate. So
I don't know, with all the spaghetti code that exists in Riot, I would not be surprised if I see that MF start sliding across the floor during her bullet time. I mean, that'd be cool, man. AoE bullet time, it's already big. Make it bigger.
Yeah, that's what I start moonwalking across, right? That would be hilarious.
I want her to start spinning in a circle, like a water fountain.
Like a 360, just like a 360 bullet time.
There you go. Wipe the floor with the whole squad.
You know, and so, what do we look for in regards to, you know, it's only a 2k gold lead for Degenerates Esports, but it looks like they kind of, you know, are in the driver's seat. Where do you look for Degenerates Reform to kind of make a comeback, if any? Is it at this Baron fight? Is it this split push with Yorick? Is it just these, you know, very long attrition battles regards with the Senna and the Seraphine? Like, how do they get back into this game and, you know, get the gold lead that they almost had earlier on?
Right, I think it's in their potential. They still have a great team fight comp to play around, and you've got Dragon, Baron still up. These are major points to play. You have to pay your respects towards Fug and Sovereign if you want to find any success into those team fights, as they are currently in a very great position to dissuade the backline presence from Crimvale and Fox Zero especially. But if they can find kind of the numbers advantage, maybe go back to playing around Adderall, split pushing. I mean, we haven't seen that, and the last time he pulled it off, we saw two turrets go down from his presence alone. But either way, we do see the engage here from Reform. The Incar does find its way through as the Onslaught pushes through from Sovereign there, but
nothing really to play off of. They do get the root out in response, but no one's going down as they're just pressuring each other further and further away from that fight. Lots of windows, but no kills.
Yeah, a whole lot of just nothing. It's like when two guys are getting ready to fight, and they're both just kind of shoving at each other back and forth, not really any punches thrown. It's kind of what it looked like over there in the jungle, you know, an ultimate here, an ability there, a stun here, and then kind of just walk away with their lives. You know, not the action that I was hoping to see. Just such a big tease from both of these teams.
Hey, it's okay by me. That's something they both specialize in. Especially when it comes to teasing each other, as they are technically from the same org. But either way, definitely good. We did see a hard engage from Reformed, and it could have gone so wrong, especially Sovereign getting back into it with the onslaught of Shadows. Didn't quite get that same kind of fear response, especially as they were in such a bad choke point to play off of a team, team fight presence. So it really didn't work out either way. Like we saw, you know, your analogy, you know, two guys just kind of going, "Yo, bro, let's go, man. Outside! Right now, dude!" There you go. Same concept, just imagine Degenerate Esports and Reformed.
Yeah, and really, Sovereign has been looking for these big 3-4-man ultis, and he's been kind of getting them, right? These fears have been super crucial to setting up the Magnet Storms, but like you mentioned, he kind of dove into the backline without really any... Oh!
No. Not quite. It felt like it. I like how Flute steps out, like, "Come back! Please! Just..." Yeah. Just one casket.
Yeah, he's trying to give him some alcohol, free alcohol, right? Trying to bait Degenerate Esports out. But yeah, these huge ultimates by Sovereign have been so impactful, right? Setting him up when the Magma Storm can't, and then just giving all this AoE damage to MF. And now MF is a threat, right? She's on 2-3 items, right? She's gonna start shredding your tanks and your backline. Oh,
Adderall, poor positioning. All four members from Esports to collapse onto the man himself. The Maiden's not gonna save the day at this point. Cole finding himself another kill to bolster the 6-0 lead he's garnered.
Yeah, and it feels like TF is just solely there to counter every and all of Adderall's plays, right? No matter where he goes, you know, Coldbox will be there ready to just ult on top of you. And then the sheer speed of Hecarim with his E and how he can get across the map is so annoying. I don't know how Yorick can really play into this. Has the Triforce, has the Tiamat and the Deadmans. He's probably just going to keep looking to split push.
What are you doing? That's the whole point, buddies. I know, no, Hot S'mores is completely up. You've got Fox Zero on that top side. I feel like this is such a poor show of macro from Reformed here. I mean, no contestion. They just let this one go. And while they may argue that, we can't really take the team fight 4v5, they don't pick up anything in response from the play either. You know, no Baron set up at all, no real waves pushing. It's just a massive loss.
Yeah, they kind of get nothing for it, right? Maybe Seta gets some souls. They get some chip damage onto the mid lane. Yeah, you would love to see them at least dance around Tango with them.
Oh. Hot S'mores. Stormbringer used immediately. Onslaught Shadows into that backline, pushing back Hot S'mores. Flute Loop steps up to get a good explosive casket, but it's not where it needs to be. Fear Beyond Death into the back to get a massive double taunt from Fugnuggler. Steps through as Cole is there as well to pick up the back as Crimson Fox go down. Now Adderall, the only one left alive here, but he's not going to even have the chance to defend as Baron is now in the minds of Degenerate Esports.
Man, Esports is just so far ahead right now. That Cloud Soul, you know, actually putting in a bit of work. You saw Hecarim ulted and just kind of be annoying with the amount of damage he gets, you know, getting the extra damage based off of his movement speed. And, you know, really Rell was kind of in the backline being honest. But that 2-3, I think it was a 2-man fear beyond death from Fugnuggler was just game-changing, right?
It was fantastic. That's exactly what you need to see. We talked about Sovereign and Fug earlier. We wanted to see them get into this backline, and Sovereigns have been doing a great job. Unstoppable coming through with the massive fear on that onslaught of Shadows. But Fug, finally, this is the exact presence of the Urgot that we've been waiting for. A good fear beyond death into a massive fear, specifically. Yeah, crazy. Fear beyond death into a fear. It's almost like their name for some reason. But either way, beautiful. Plays off of Crimveil Fox Zero. They don't have the damage to respond. They don't have the peel themselves, and just collapses.
Yeah, and really I'd like to see the Degenerate Esports kind of get into a 1-3-1 composition, right? Put TF in the top lane, put Urgot in the bot lane, and get, you know, MF, Rell, and Hecarim in the mid, and just kind of pressure all these lanes. Because right now, nobody can answer Urgot, right? You have to send more than one to him. You know, this Yorick can only really hope to, you know, 1v1 this guy, but really he's just so far ahead right now. Urgot is just, you know, can put out so much damage. He's going to look to get on.
Yeah, it's going
to
be hot s'mores. He's taking low instantly there, but the rest of Degenerates Esports look for that response. Kobox into that backline, going to get the root off the gold card. Flash comes through from hot s'mores, goes back into it because of a massive Fear Beyond Death snipe. Beautiful job as Fug pulls that one for himself. This team now going to rush for his onslaught of shadows, finds its way where it needs to onto Floob's big flash as he does dash out of that one, not quite going down, but the windows are expended. Good explosive casket to deny the misfortune ultimate. Meanwhile, though, other side of the map. Great Dawn of Shadow, but on the other side of the map, you have Fugnuggler taking the turret, taking the inhib. This is the split push Yorick we've been waiting for, baby.
Go for it all.
I don't think he can, man. Fugnuggler and Sovereign are too strong for this guy. He's going to try to heal it. He's going to try to run away, but he's still going to go down as a result.
That's so good for Reform Scythe, right? Getting the inhib up there just slows down, you know, nullifies the lane that they can push with this Baron, and now this Baron's being wasted, right? They didn't get really anything. Oh.
Oh, Bixis. Good playthrough, good route. Burn in hell, taking advantage. The double carries alone in a bush. I mean, that's got to feel bad. There's no way for them to get out of that.
Just as I praise them, just as I praise the Genesis Reformed and their gameplay, they give me this. They both of their, you know, crucial team members die. I mean, not anything really to take up. Can't really push out any lanes. It looks like Hecarim and Urgot are in the top lane trying to get what they can out of this Baron. You know, the two outers have gone out now in the top and bot lane, but really that's not what you want to see with this Baron. You want to try to see them get an inhib at least one.
They might. That's a good engage on to Flute Loops, and he's actually taken out immediately. Sovereign picks that one up. Hot s'mores now the only one left to defend topside. Adderall's going to rush the best that he can to get in this one. There's the launch for, but a teleport coming through from Kolbox. It's going to be the 3v2 now as they continue to aggress in this lane. Fox is back up. You've got Crim Veil. Adderall steps forward, but he's going to be pressured out. Big Stormbringer here from Hot s'mores to get the root instantly. There's the onslaught. Shouse into that back line, but Sovereign can't quite find what he needs to. Both of them just going to end up inevitably having to walk away. But meanwhile, does it really matter? The inhibit is still secured from Degenerate Esports, just on the bot side.
Yeah, and they trade, you know, Fugnuggler's life for that inhib, you know. Even then, it looked like Degenerate Esports almost had the 3v4 in the bag. You would imagine if Rel or MF was there, even one of them, they probably would have turned around and got the top inhib as well. But, you know, not horrible for Degenerates Reformed getting the shutdown. I believe Volibear got it, unfortunately, but, you know, not the worst champion to give it to. You know, this kind of trade, you know, this is what Reformed needs to do. They might need to just trade objectives for kills and get the gold back onto some of their crucial carries. As we see, you know, the three item Senna coming out with the Kraken Slayer, with the Rage Blade and Rapid Fire Cannon. He's looking to just scale with souls, and, you know, hopefully you can get a soul count eventually, but I want to say he's probably at like 120, 140. Ideally, that's where you kind of want to be. I know at this stage of the game, if not at 200, but, you know.
Currently 73, baby.
Oh, man. That's, you know, they're not playing around the win condition.
I was about to say, Pwn, you're going to be really upset here in a second.
Yeah, 75 souls at 35 minutes is not what should be happening. You know, you're playing Fasting Senna. Not that fasted, though. I mean,
that's not Fasting Senna. That is full CS Senna.
Yeah, I mean, these I don't really like the 80 carry Senna, and the fact that they're not even trying to play around the souls. You know, you can get so many souls if you just follow your jungler around. But looks like they want to adjust for this Elder.
Yeah, Reform doing great job to put the pressure there. They throw that wall out from Adderall. They're going to start this one up, even though there's still full team fight presence. Big teleport going to be coming through from Fugnuggler. Encore comes through, but still the onslaught of shadows makes its way forward there. Now Kolbox using that destiny to get behind Fox here, take him out in response. Now Flute Loops, the double from Cole as well. The rest of the team now collapsing through. His Adderall and Hotsmore still get a good response from Bixis and Burn in Hell playing too far forward, but it's only Hotsmores and Adderall now to contest this Drake, and I don't think they're going to be able to do it.
Can they be the heroes that Degenerates Reformed need? Can Volibear come up with the hero steal? Probably
not. They're already leaving.
No, come on. Flip it here. You guys are down so much. Just go in, give your life. You know, Degenerates Esports has been shredding Reformed already. I can't even imagine the amount of Elder Dragon screams we're going to see within the next 2 minutes. These Exekutes are going to come out. Baron is coming up. They're probably going to turn their attention to that and then just close out the game through mid and top. It kind of looks in the bag for esports. I don't think Reform can kind of come back from this. Just the, you know, Fox Zero has not been able to get any damage off. I would love to see the end game damage from her just because it's, you know, she's been getting jumped on Onslaught of Shadows into the Urgot kill, into this TF stat. I mean, she hasn't been allowed to play the game at all. This bot lane hasn't been allowed to play at all. Look, they're 2-10.
I mean, this goes back to Drapik. Like I said, to make this team comp work, you need a real sense of community, cohesion, playing around each other efficiently. If not, it falls apart so quickly because Sovereign in your backline, instantly Foxeer is gone, Crimveil's gone, Floop's too far forward as Hot S'mores wants to engage with them, and suddenly massive separation, and there's no real consistency. I'm sorry. To what they want to do as a composition, and it's paying the price. Fox Zero has never found himself in a comfortable position this entire game. So it's not quite over just yet, but it's definitely time to start thinking of how is Reformed going to approach game two.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they're trying to go for the split push with Yorick and
Fugs there. I don't know if Fug's going to be able to stop it, but it does put hope into the hands of Reform. They know it's a 4v4 as it stands currently. Fug doesn't have teleport. Adderall does. If any team fight goes on here, it would be the perfect time for Reformed. But I think esports, they're going to pull back, assess what is going to be that Baron, and just go for that instead.
Yeah, I mean, Elder Dragon's still on them for another minute and a half, roughly. So even if any engage they want to kind of do, you can't do it. Just, the moment you get below execution range, you're done for, and that's a lot. Actually, I lied. Elder Dragon's... it's still on them. It's still on them. It's just
either way, huge engage. As Flute Loops is too far forward, taken out. Onslaught Shadows, Fox Zero, name one better combo. The two of them as Fox Zero going to go down as well once again. Now Crimveil. He's far forward. Big flash knockup from Burn in Hell to secure a double. And this team, it's not even a fight. It is literally just a pick after pick walking into it one by one. Reformed here. No real response. Fugs deep into the back line. Doesn't even have the team with him. And he's taking that 2v1. Hot S'mores, you may look big and strong, but you're still not finding that kill.
Yeah, Degenerous Esports, it's just like they're taking the lunch money from Reformed over here. You know, just kind of picking and choosing who they kill and when and who they get the bully as we... See, game one gonna be closed out without the Baron.
Maybe
closed out.
No, it'll be closed out, Pwn. They're gonna go in here. They're gonna find these double kills, pad their record a little bit. But either way, even if Flute Loops comes through here, tries to get the cask up, tries to push him into Fountain, Degenerates Esports take the pace and pressure Reform into game one.
Yeah, and a really strong showing, you know, in the mid to the late game from Degenerous Esports. It looked pretty even in the early game. The first 15 to 20 minutes, you know, it was pretty even, but then Degenerous Esports kind of taking away with, you know, superior macro and some, you know, macro mishaps from Degenerate Esports, you know, giving up that Cloud Soul, you know, not really being in the way to contest any of these, losing that early Cloud Dragon with the steal. You would have loved to see them kind of hold the dragon at a certain HP and try to burst Sovereign out, but really good stuff from Sovereign, I think. You know, like you mentioned, Degenerate Esports Catalyst, he is their engine, and he really drove this team to succeed, right? Corebox putting impressive 9-1, 10 in score, Fugnuggler getting a 7-4-12. These guys really carrying the mid to late game and just getting some fantastic flanks off. So if you're Degenerate Reformed, you know, where do you go from here? Do you ban Hecarim? Do you ban Twisted Fate? Like, is it a certain champion that's messing them up? Was it their comp? Was it a mix of both? Like, how do you respond?
Well, personally, I think the strength of Degenerates Esports is going to come through no matter what they draft through. You can ban it out, but they still have a wide pool of champions to play around and form these aggressive team fight compositions that really scale up and pressure out whoever they play against. Reformed, on the other hand, this is not a great showing from them. This is not really a comp that I'm used to them playing. There's not a huge precedent on setting up Fox Zero in any way. Crimveil, while he is strong on that Seraphine, is not in the best position as well because there's not much peel from the rest of the team to enable their major carries, and damage as a whole really wasn't there for this composition as well. So going into that second draft, I need to see them orient some more like true hard carry control to both Crimveil and Fox Zero, and maybe some stemming of the bleeding and less more full-on tank, full-on frontline engage here from S'mores or Flute or Adderall. Maybe something a bit more half and half.
Yeah, and the Seraphine is only really strong in the mid lane when you can kind of power up these these high damage carries. You know, Seraphine couldn't really do much, right, with the team comp. You saw that she was throwing out heals, but it was just too much, right? Builds the Moonstone, gets the staff, goes into the Chemtech, and then gets into Cosmic Drive just to kind of live a little bit longer with the HP. But, you know, nobody was really there to do any damage on Reform side, like you mentioned. I don't know if I necessarily like the split push approach from Adderall. I would have loved to see a more team fight, you know, zone control kind of tank. Yorick doesn't really provide a lot in these team fights unless he's kind of set up properly. I like the Volibear pick. He did do really well early game and trying to counter Sovereign's ganks, but it kind of just showed, you know, the sheer difference in jungle champions, right? Hecarim being, you know, top tier jungler, his clear speed, his engage, his damage is just so much better than Volibear. So, you know, if you're gonna ban away junglers, I definitely think you should ban away the Nocturne. That's another champion similar to what Sovereign was playing in the Hecarim that can just kind of be disruptive, get in the back line, blow up whoever needs to. But I think give the Elise away, you know, give these other jungle champions away and just kind of put it on an even playing field in terms of junglers, right? Because if you're Degenerates Reformed, you have to identify that Sovereign was the one enabling this team.
I think it's a mix of problems, but I think that's a start. So we'll have to see as we approach the second draft here. We, on the other hand, are going to be going to a short break as we get these teams organized and we approach that period. Stick around. Stay tuned for what will be the next position here into this best of five.